Now let me ask a question that will hopefully help you understand what we are integrating a little bit better. Let's say from this example, which is what we had previously, I want to find only the x component of the electric field. I just want to find the electric field in this direction, and I don't want the electric field in that direction. This general electric field is going to be given as Ex in the x direction, some component in the y direction, Ey. So I only want the x component. Well, where does that come from? There's only one place that we have a vector here, and that is this unit vector right there. So let's go look there for the x component. Well, right here is the x component, and right here is the y component. So this is the piece that I want. What it means is if I want to find the electric field in only the x direction, I'm going to be doing this integration, xs, ys, over 4 pi epsilon. I'm going to put my dxs, my dys over there to give me a little bit of space. Whoops, and this is squared. And now I can see that what I've got is this magnitude, sorry, is this vector divided by its magnitude, and there's another magnitude squared down there. So I'm going to combine all of my magnitudes so that I have a cubed down on the bottom. So it's going to be 6 minus xs squared plus 3 minus ys squared cubed. And then what goes up here on the top? Only the x component, which is 6 minus xs, comes from right here, right to there. Now, do I need to write my x hat? No. My x hat shows up right here. The part that I'm finding is just ex. We're going to integrate this from x equals 0 to 2 and ys equals 1 to 3, just as we did before. And just scoot those over a little bit closer like that. So this now is a scalar integral. It's a two-dimensional integral, which is something that you have done before. It's not an integral that's very easy to integrate analytically. In fact, it may be impossible. I'm not quite sure here. But it probably is not in one of our tables. The easiest way, again, to integrate this is to use numerical integration, which you will be learning in, I believe, lab number 5. So this is a problem that is very math doable. The computer is going to be able to calculate this integral for you, and you'll have a specific number for Ex. What if you wanted to find the part for Ey instead? Well, go back up where your vector is. The only vector is this unit vector. Here's its y component, and you substitute that in instead of the x component.